Sieben.
Big Smith.
Ha ha ha. Ha ha ha.
Talk about shit that I'm excited about.
Oh yeah? Oh yeah?
All
right,
bro.
Hey, well, here's the break. Here's the come on point right here. Right there. I think that was the right there.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah, man. What you excited about?
Oh, man. This one, I feel like this one came out all right, bro.
Are we talking about the new Kingsley album? Is that what we done about? A new track?
Yeah, you know what I mean? A little track on the whatnot. Yeah, this one came together.
Oh yeah, yeah. What, explain, like, what was it about it?
Because it's the subject matter of what's being discussed with the creation of this beat. Like, the marrying of those two worlds is fantastic. You know what my favorite thing about music is? It's done. Like, it's when you do it, it's done. Like, at this point in time, I think we're all figuring out, like, what our, you know, what we'll leave with the world, like, artistically, right? Like, that's kind of always in the front of my mind. Is like, when they, hundreds of years from now, or whenever they check back at this point in time and look at the, you know, the legends that we are, what did you leave them? Right, what do they have to refer to? But oh man, you ain't never checked my quit. He had these two specials on Amazon. Like, what do you have? Oh man, you don't Lance Woods. Oh man, he was in this movie, man. He did this special. Like, what do they have to refer to? And I think the one thing that's dope about music is once you finish it, it's done, bro. It's like writing a movie in a really, it's like a movie or a sketch that's gonna kind of live forever, but in a different format, like in a different format artistically and legally, right? Because when music exists, that shit exists. Like, it gotta be registered. It gotta be the same process that a film would have to go through has to happen. So that's very, 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 very exciting to me.
Hey man, this is kind of morbid, but what about just saying this is crazy, but like posthumous IG pages, like maybe people pages should just stay open, because that is an entrance into a lot of people's work world, you know?
Absolutely. Absolutely. The collective of all the stuff that you put out, yeah, man, that should count, especially nowadays.
How many tracks are finished right now?
So like 4.5.
This nigga got an EP.
Complete
it. Yeah, like 4.5. Because one song is done for me, but it has features on it. So, and then like even last night.
I gotta wait to get the features back.
I gotta wait to get the back.
He gotta wait to get two features back, and he gotta wait for one sample to clear. This nigga is a rap.
Yeah, I gotta do one of the I gotta do one of the things that, like, last night I was right last night, and I just start hitting like chicks up trying to gain some perspective, because I couldn't find an angle. Like, I just ask y'all, what is the flip of when women don't look good? Right, we know when they look good. It's like, oh, I just got my nails done, my hair done, my outfit right. I look amazing. What's the opposite side?
Oh, I know that one. I'm comfortable.
What else?
You said that too quickly, and I heard pain in your voice when you said it.
Hey, man. this is on my mind, man. You remember how like you go out with your girl, man, and she like look bad the whole night, and you just like, woo, you checking out the clothes when she ain't looking, you looking at it from the back. She like clean, you know, she got on her hair, And then when y'all go back to the house, she take all that off, so she could be comfortable. So now, you know, you love her or whatever, so it's still great that y'all together and you spent some great time, but she's no longer in the sexy stuff because she loves you enough where she feels comfortable being comfortable around you, which is a great thing. Sometimes you just want to see whore clothes at home. That's all I'm trying to say.
Every now and then.
Yeah.
I'm comfortable and I ain't trying to impress nobody in here.
Yeah. I got weird details. When a chick was like, when I don't have on earrings, another chick was like, if I don't get my brows done, I was like, really? That's the one. The eyebrows, huh? She's like, if I don't get my brows done, I am not myself.
It's once I put my bonnet on, because it's bonnet. A lot of stuff that's like, once I put this on, I'm no longer leaving the house. Once I put my glasses on.
I got reading glasses in there. Yeah, reading glasses.
Hey, that's what it used to be. This bonnets and airport thing is real.
You in Atlanta, right?
I'm in Atlanta, and I'm telling you, I've seen a lot of airport bonnets. It's a thing. They are decorative. I seen some extraordinary ones, like decorative colors booming, and I've seen some that did not belong in the airport. I'm like, wait, you really wore this in the shower? Like, it's still a little dry off the side. So, man, I'm seeing it.
So maybe that's Monique's issue. Maybe Monique lives in Atlanta, and she thinks it's an epidemic because in Atlanta it is.
That's possible.
Because you're in Atlanta right now.
I'm in Atlanta. Yeah, man.
Because the LA airport, girls be in the airport with red bottoms on.
Right. Hey, man. We had this conversation last week, and I want to come back to the girl thing, the dress thing. But we were talking about what we wear in the airport, right? So, man, let's just say this morning I 3-piece suited up. And let me tell you what happened. Hey, man, look, you can pay for first class. That's cool. But it always feels good when they just move you to first class. So that happened this morning. What else happened? I got allowed to check in early at my in the room, and they didn't have any rooms. First, she was like, she didn't have any rooms. But when I walk in, man, with the vest, the 3-piece, a room became available.
The cummerbund gained some respect.
It really did, man. And you know, my wife, she clowned in the suit, and she like said it looked old or whatever. And I'm like, it don't matter how it looked. You know, it's how I accessorize it.
Yeah.
You know, so she was like, get a number then. I was like, I will. I mean, I wasn't into getting a number that early, man. Like, I was focused on, like, just, you know, it was early.
I love that she said get a number, not get number, just one.
Yeah, she challenged me or whatever. But, hey, man, it's world of difference.
The respect level changed.
Yeah, man. And it's like, I mean, we all know this. There's people, billionaires in jean shorts and cutoff tees sitting in first class. That ain't nothing. But it's just that whole perception of a suit that just gives someone this aura of, oh, something's important. And it just come with it.
You know what's funny about a suit? It don't matter if it's old or new. A suit's a suit. You could have on, because the suit says you're either important or you got somewhere important to be. Now, how old or new or fitted or unfitted it might be, that start talking to your style efforts. But if you could have on an old ass raggedy suit, but somebody be like, oh, that boy got something important going on. This is the best suit he got. He put on his best outfit, no matter how bad or good a suit is. You have one of them baggy ass Steve Harvey Zoot suits, it'd be like, shit, but something going on.
Something going on.
Yeah.
My man's got on the airplane for a court date. He could have just paid the ticket, but nope, he got on a plane to fight it.
Ah, yeah, man. So I'm on some, you know, whenever you feel like it, highly recommend it. But whenever you feel like it, and today, today was that day, you know.
Did you get upgraded to first class?
I did, man. And it was,
and you
like,
left the wife and coach? Oh, this nigga ain't shit.
Yeah,
bro.
Man. You know, man.
She should have wore a suit.
She got to wear a suit. I told her.
She saw what I was bringing to the table.
That's her. Get that fucking bonnet off and go sit back there with the bonnet crew.
If you want to be comfortable. Gonna be comfortable as fuck back there, coach.
But me and mine is gonna sit in first class. Where we belong.
Mikey sitting up there with his suit on, keep checking his pocket watch.
Yeah, man. I had the little thing that you pull up with the chain with the monocle. I had the monocle on, man. Right. That was like Mr. Peanut or whatever, man. I went hard on him.
Oh, that's funny, man. You got to tell these people what's going on, Mike.
Yo, man, I don't know. What you talking about?
It's a. I don't know what episode we on.
Oh. Hey, everybody. Welcome. Play the beat. Welcome to Black D University, everybody. Episode number, hope I don't get kicked out the room for the noise, 43, everybody. Episode 43 here. Mikey Winfield here with...
Are we 43? I think we're 44.
Let me check.
I don't know. Either way, I know 50 is right before the show. BT Kangsley in this thing. You know,
I'm going to find out. I'm about to find out right now.
Lance Woods here. We're trying to figure this out for y'all, people.
Yeah, man. Damn it. What did I say?
43.
Episode 44, everybody. Yeah. University. Episode number 44. It's double four.
It's a funny call. This is hilarious.
A four and a four. Yeah. It's
Reed.
Yeah.
Hold on, you on speakerphone. I got BT Kingsley and Mikey Winfield with me.
What's up, BT and Mike?
What up? The great.
Oh, that Rico. What up, Rico?
What's going on, man? Shit.
Hey, ain't shit to it, man.
What's going on?
Hey, man, I ain't doing nothing. I'll just call and see what was up.
All right, I appreciate you, Rico the Great.
Hey, what y'all doing, the podcast?
Yeah.
Y'all keep prodding and shit, man. Get your shit together, man.
Oh, God. Look, nigga, I'm going to tell you how funny you are. What'd you say?
Get me on that motherfucker one time, man.
Of course. You know how to use Zoom, right?
Did he say no?
Yeah, nigga.
Hey, Rick, I'm gonna tell you what's funny about you.
What's that?
You just, when you start talking, niggas just start laughing because we know something funny coming.
I was calling you about something, man. Bro, tell me the other day. She's sticking out your hair with her laugh.
Talk like this.
Man, <I'm> like, I'll call you when we done. All right, love you back, G.
All right, love you, bro. It's because that nigga talk like this. Come on, man. Hey, motherfucking nigga shit. Put nigga, we keep potting and shit, nigga.
Yeah. Hey man, a thing about Rico, no matter what time of day you hear him, it sounds like it's the morning.
Right. No matter what. Yeah.
It's the morning voice. All
you know what it is too? Rico is like he is a Northern Cali, like he a Bay nigga. Like you can like remember when they did the verses and I was like, nah. The craziest shit to me is Short is clearly a Bay nigga, but 40 is obviously also a Bay nigga. Like it's two versions, but it's two versions of a very similar thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's like it's like meeting the LA street nigga or like a Hollywood nigga. It's like, no, both these motherfuckers from LA. But they different.
Yeah.
This nigga 40 nigga, he's dumbass.
Yeah, man. That's my favorite part, man.
Right, nigga. That was the best verse. You're not gonna get. I'm sorry, bro. That was by if just the energy alone.
Oh yeah. My just favorite. The energy my favorite alone. Easily. Right.
That's the only verses where them niggas where Timbaland and fucking Swiss Beats were like, them niggas still going, bro. We just gotta do the recap. They not. I'm sleeping, nigga.
Imagine that versus with the setup they got now with the like concert.
Oh my gosh.
Mm.
Woo! Mm. That shit was bananas, nigga.
What was the first one that was set up like that? Was it Meth and Red?
With the audience, I don't know. I feel like what's the name of them? The Steve Harvey one had an
Earth,
audience.
Wind and Fire and all
yeah.
that.
Yeah,
right.
I know they had an audience, but they were still in a different confined setting. The last two looked like they were on big ass rap battle stages.
Yeah. Oh, it might have been those last two. That might have been Red, nigga, Mike. You right. It was Earth, Wind and Fire. Fucking Steve Harvey interjected so much, I called it the Steve Harvey verse. I was like, yeah, the Steve Harvey verses. No, that nigga didn't verse it. It was Earth, Wind, and Fire and fucking the Isley Brothers, and I almost forgot.
Yo, Steve Harvey.
Who
does
Steve
everybody.
Harvey have a verses with? That fucking toupee?
His mustache. Godfrey. No, maybe I don't know. I think Bernie's the obvious choice.
Steve Harvey would have a versus against would be Bernie.
It gotta be Bernie. It gotta be Bernie because of their history. Or alleged history or whatever.
Oh, we got another phone call. Yo.
Yo, he know he was sent the link, right?
He sent the link every Tuesday and Thursday.
To Tony.
he said, you know you were sent the link, right?
Yeah, you know, I got better shit to do. Like, my Are y'all live from the class?
Lance is from this background. I can see Ant the Hustler's signature back there.
Oh man. Ant the Hustler. Pour some out.
My nigga, the dirty knee. I love y'all nigga, man.
Pull up, nigga. This nigga Tony crazy ass. This nigga Bobby Brown, bro.
Hey, man.
Yeah, we here. I'm hit you when we done with this.
All right.
Yeah, how y'all, but nigga, so Trina Eve, how you feel? Straight like that, huh? No, fun.
I don't know any of their music like that. I know more Eve's music because I was so into the Rough Riders. So I ain't gonna say nothing. I know. I don't know much of Trina's music.
Man, let me say something, man. East Coasters, specifically New York, probably Philly, Jersey. Y'all bias is ridiculous. Y'all bias is ridiculous. This nigga Clint Coley said, does Trina even have 20 songs? And he was like, I got 20-0 Eve in a landslide. I say, yo, listen, man, that's East Coast bias. They really, because if you're anywhere else in the country, right, you were, you understand East Coast shit and its greatness, right? Not even in a diss, like you understand how dope it is, but you, but if you're in the East Coast bubble, you miss a lot of shit.
Mm-hmm. Amen. I was in that bubble before I came to Cali, man. I was in that bubble where.
Oh, yeah, because you're in Baltimore. Yeah, yeah.
Right. So I wonder, do West Coast feel like this too? When they, like back in the day, they look at East Coast and feel like, yo, it just wasn't worthy. Like when I was in the East and I saw Bay Music, it was just like, yo, y'all for real? You serious? It wasn't until I came out here and, you know, I got family in the Crest. I got family in the Bay, you know, and you finally, it all added up and made sense. But I was in the bubble where I was like, I don't get it. So I see it, how, where it comes from.
Yeah, I think it's it's interesting because, like, I remember being in Texas, but feeling the 50 Cent thing. I remember the Texas DJs having the 50 Cent mixtapes, nigga. Like, all them bitches, nigga. Bought it out, all them bitches. I heard them all. And I was like, oh, this guy's great. But at no point in time did I ever be like, well, I mean, UGK, them niggas is garbage. It's just like, it just be funny. Like, to say, yes, I believe Eve probably has more hits, but nigga, Trina. Well, if she got shit, she got I don't know now. She got you don't know now. She got you don't know now.
What they both got is they were on songs that weren't their song, and they're going to be like, oh shit, I forgot she had a verse on this.
Yes.
Yo, there's a Lil Wayne track called Wowzers that I bump on repeat.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's on the I Am Not a Human Being 2 album.
Mm-hmm.
And it slaps.
Yeah.
It slaps. It's a good all around track from both of them. And the beat hits. But how can that even come up? That can come up when you were, that can come up when you were
featured. The features is what be making the verses. I mean, you got Five Star Chick with Yo Gotti. That's, I mean, technically, clearly, Nicki is the one that gassed out on that song, but she on that bitch. She on that bitch. And I'm willing to bet that there's some more. The Ass So Big Like a Sun. I know they played the fuck out of that song. She got enough. Fuck everything I'm talking about. It's Trina. It's not like it's not Trina, bro. It's like we know who Trina is, if nothing else. It's just like that bias be aggressive, bro. Yeah. That bias be aggressive. And that was that.
That's the thing about art, man. You know, it's subjective. Some of them they love it, and some of them they like, I hate that person. And it's it brings emotion.
Mm. Oh, My Chick Bad remix. Yeah.
Yeah, she got the
Trina's all over there.
What's your fantasy?
That's not Trina.
That's not Trina on the remix.
You talking about Shauna? That's Shauna.
No, she was on the remix.
She was?
If I remember right, yeah.
All right.
Hmm.
Because the What's Your Fantasy remix had.
It got Shauna on it too?
Let me go to my Googles.
She must have, she must have spit hella hard on that for you not to remember that one.
No, yeah. No. Yeah. It has Foxy Brown on it. Okay. And Trina.
And Shauna.
So okay. I think it's like a bunch of women on it.
Yeah. So that's a very interesting thing. When these conversations come up and they do songs like that where it'd be a bunch of chicks on the remix. Very often is Trina. Very often is Trina.
Why? They didn't like her?
No, I'm saying it wasn't Eve.
Oh, I got you. Right. Amen. But Eve went into her bubble and started acting. She started branching out and doing other things, man. She wasn't in those circles like that.
Yeah, and Trina, and then Trina has like some very, she got some songs that I know women love, like I'm not, it's just like very girly songs that, like Single Again and shit like that, that I think is like super trash, but I have testicles, so it's like, this ain't for me. But that shit, I know women love that song. I know some chicks that love that song, but side note, Eve had went into that bag for a little bit too. I always feel like that's the female rapper, bag of death. Like, don't do that. Don't just make these female sounding sounds. They stopped doing that. I want to say Nicki. Nicki will always take it back to the streets. When she need one, she'll always go get, like, I don't know when producers just started saying, we gonna give the girls the best beats, but that started happening. And it's like, nigga, sometimes Beyonce come on, I'll be like, this is hard to ignore.
Okay, wait, so wait a minute. You're saying that women rappers can't stay in what? An emotional bag of lyrics? Or what are you saying? What songs can't they make?
So like, okay, so
like those Carrie Hilson songs where it just be just all women, that
kind of, but not really that. So, all right. So women, for female rappers will get on very often on some hard shit, right? Because niggas is just digesting the music and we need hard beats and hard lyrics. And if she nice, you be like, nice. Like you, it'll almost bypass you what her, that she's a woman, right? But then every now and then, as they get big, they'll do like a few songs that just have this, it got a schoolgirl, like a sleepover vibe. It just like, wear your pajamas. Like Single Again's hook is like, I'm single again, I'm back on the grind. It's just like annoying and like poppy and like kind of whiny, and it's just like, but it ain't shit it on him. Like, you know what I mean? Like when the Nicki was always very aware of it. I'll give you a perfect example. Nicki went to a pop bag for a little bit. Not the female rap song bag, but kind of similar, chasing the same thing, yeah, right? And then she went right back to Bees in the Trap. Like, Nicki always go back to street shit. She's like, whoa, almost lost you niggas. Wait, come back. Come back, almost lost you niggas. If you hear Single Again, you'll know what I'm talking about. Eve did it too. Eve did it and they always do it on their way out.
So were these singles or were these like just on the album?
No, these are like album. No, these are like album number four lead singles.
Oh, yeah. I mean, if it's just single, I hear where you're coming from. But it seems like you should be, if you an artist, you put everything on there. But if it's just single and that's what you're dropping, you're going to lose some fans.
I'm going to tell you how different it feels. Remember Luda did the song with Old Girl? When he was like, everybody kept telling Luda, you'll be talking about shit. And he finally like did a song where he was talking about shit. He was like,
oh, yeah. Oh, that song was so bad. You talking about, what was the name of that song? That was on the,
Body and the Body Turn Cold. Dibba Jibba Diddy and the Nigga.
Oh, my goodness. That song was so bad.
It feels the same way. It was like, but I got Mary J. Blige on the song. And it's like, nigga, the songs from the women be feeling that same way. It's just like, what are you doing? Like, this is not what we here for. But nowadays, the producers be like giving the girls the slapping ass beats. It's like,
the song did have Mary J. Blige on it. It was called Runaway Love. Runaway Love. Oh yeah, that song.
Every time you say that, I always say,
gang violence is whack. A little kid got shot in the back. that song was tough to listen to.
Yeah, man, but how do we fix the problems in the inner city without lyrics like this?
I ain't gonna hold you. When Jada did it with Y, I was like, Boo, nigga!
No, you weren't. No, you weren't. No, you weren't. Why? Why is a memorable hit single?
Where's Knock Yourself Out and Melissa Ford, nigga? This is what I need.
I don't know.
Girl, month. Yay!
Yo, man, but hey,
Why
man.
Is way better, though? Why is way better than
Why
that?
Is a classic?
Ugh.
Why is a classic song?
No, hey, you know what's funny? The funny thing about Why was when he redid it.
Oh, he kept trying to capture it again. That might be his biggest song.
It is his biggest song.
I would believe it.
It's probably his highest charting song, but his fan base and reputation doesn't come from charts.
You're damn right.
You know, so nobody give a fuck what Jadakiss's highest charting song is.
Yeah.
But for that conversation, it's like, oh yeah, that was the highest charting one. But Jadakiss's fan base is in the streets. So yeah. I can't tell you what, well, yes, I can, but I was gonna say I can't tell you what like Styles' highest charting song is, but I know his highest charting song was I get high
every day. Right. Great song. But, I love Styles P.
Hey, yeah, man, but Styles P core fan base don't give a fuck about charts.
I like Styles P too, man. And there's a song he got out that I like always connect on some of them slow jams, right? The rap slow jams. Yeah. But he got a song called Holiday, and all it says is Holiday.
Oh, that was on the back in the day on the Rough Rider. On the Rough Rider.
Oh my God, that's a cut. It's a cut though.
And yo, Styles, the appeal that we had towards Style P was ridiculous violence. Mm. It was like over the top, because that song you talking about, the opening bar, I believe, is if you heard it from the P, you ought to know it's the truth. I get you kidnapped and raped and thrown off the roof. And we was 13, like, yeah, spit that.
Nigga.
It's like, yo, what the? Oh, what God. Are we listening to?
Yeah.
Hey, what, Mike, what do you let your kids listen to? Like if they just in the car with you, mom ain't around, what are you jamming?
Hey, man, we bumping the same stuff, really, at this point. You know what I mean? So, hey, man, I was on a road trip, right? So what I did is we got Amazon Music, and they use it. I kind of use it. They use it. So I went through all of the recently played song to hear and understand what they listening to. And it was, I'm gonna tell you some of the people. So it's a lot of, it's a name. Y'all gonna know him. I know y'all gonna know him. I ain't gonna know him. I mean, it was a lot of NBA Young Boy. I know him, right? But man, it was this.
I don't know you, NBA Young Boy song. Exactly. I know that nigga.
Right. So then, man, what about Quinn Neffin? It's Q-U-I-N-N-F-N.
You talk about NFN? No, that's DJ Effin. He does Drink Champs with Nori.
So he got one track.
His name is DJ EFN, right?
Oh, yeah.
So, man, he got a song called Talking My Shit. And I think that's his opening track. And I think that's probably the hottest track on the album. And then the rest just kind of, it flounder. All right, man, what about this one? Spot 'em, got 'em.
No, Spot 'em, got 'em. Hit them on my two-step. I know Spot 'em, got 'em.
Let me ride.
Want to get it started. Bitch, I got two lips. Oh, here go. All right. Yeah, I know.
Hey, man, I mean, this is old school. It was a lot of Chief Keef in there. I think this is my wife playing this, man. That Uzi Vert homecoming song.
Nigga, that is hilarious.
I guess Nicki's in that. So she be all on this Nicki stuff or whatever, you know. Who else? Future.
Gotta get some Future in there.
Lil Baby.
Yeah.
And, hey man, did y'all? I bumped this Cordae album, you know, because I was just like, let me see what this is about.
I know Cordae can spit his ass off. I haven't. I've listened to it in spots, But I haven't like just like been able to sit and like digest the whole album.
That's the whole thing. Me either. I mean, no, I couldn't. But the closing, yeah, yeah, that cut right there. Don't it slap though? We just can't play it or they'll ban the episode or whatever.
Hey, no,
I had to mute my joint so I could play this to myself. And I'm like, yo, your kids know how to pick them.
Yo, they got some tracks, man.
What's the song called?
It's called Talking My Shit.
Yo, and that track alone, if he would have spit like that through the whole album, I might have a new rapper in the rotation. But I just got that song in the rotation.
Well, that's the thing about that. Unless I'm missing something.
Wait, Talking My Shit is who?
It's Quinn NFN.
And he spells it Q-U-I-N.
See, this is the thing about that song, Mike. It's on no album that I see.
What's that, like a mixtape?
It looked like it's just a loose song.
No, okay.
He got two albums here, but that's on neither one of the albums.
Oh, that's
so weird. It's just listed as a single.
Now y'all hold on, wait. I'll be back. I'll be going to listen.
It made me want to hear it again real quick, man, because yo, he did. He spit on that one. It's like, damn. So I've been bumping that joint. It's a lot of NBA young boy. A lot.
This nigga 11.
King Von is on here a lot.
Oh, yeah.
They slipped in, man, the old school classic they got on here. Listen to this. 6 foot, 7 foot. That's on there.
He's like, yo, we're going to play something old school.
Right.
6 foot, 7 foot.
Now I dare y'all to go listen to Single Again. Cause the way Single Again holds up next to like a I'ma tell you, nigga, when I was like all in on Cardi. Cardi did the song with 21 Savage, nigga. Cardi and the Barty and the Rari, skirt, nigga. I was like, fucks with this bitch. You hear me?
Yo. I like Cardi flow a lot.
Cardi's hilarious too. Flow wise, she be funny as shit. I don't know if that's her or Fonte, but somebody over there funny as shit.
Somebody got the comedic timing and gift.
Man, nigga, I like Cardi's flow a lot. I think her weird accent, her New York accent meets the Dominican thing, meets like a lisp, makes for a great rap voice.
Hey, man, she's interestingly logical. Like, she got a strong point of view. Whether you agree with it all, it's thought out. It ain't just, like, spit out and thrown out. So I respect it.
Top 10 bars ever. Diamond's gonna hit like a bitch on a bitch-ass bitch.
Ooh. Damn.
Diamond's gonna hit like a bitch on a bitch-ass bitch.
So that could have been on Illmatic, that bar right there.
Woo! Raekwon, who? That bitch say, Diamond's gonna hit like a bitch on a bitch-ass bitch.
Hey, man. All right, look at this. Look at this segue. So, I shouldn't have announced it. So, Cardi used to be a stripper. T-Pain, I'm in love with a stripper. He confesses on a podcast. Was it? Yeah, Mike Tyson's podcast, that he never meant it. That it was just something his brother was going through or something, and he just used it for inspiration, and he wanted to give back to the strippers. Like, he wanted them to make money, and this was the song that put a lot of dollars in their pocket.
Such a great guy.
If you make songs for strippers, you can make money, you say.
Yeah, man.
What's the name of your stripper song?
No, yet.
No, what's your take? What's your take? Because he was in love with him. What do you want to do with him?
Oh, man. This is interesting. Can't say no sex in the champagne room. They did that already.
Right.
And that was a lie.
Like, if it was me, I would want to talk to them, you know, for long periods of time and just understand you know, how they operate in life, because they're good business people a lot of times.
Can I get a lap dance with no glitter on me? Hey, with no glitter on me.
Because you seen Kanye, the story, who knows if it's true, but I don't know if it was a stripper or a sex worker, prostitute, whatever the name they got now, pussy saleswoman. But she said Kanye paid her $15,000 just to listen to him talk for 3 hours.
That don't sound weird, though.
It sound weird that she was paid to listen, and now she talking. Bitch, he paid you to listen. Why are you telling the people this story?
Where's the anonymity?
You know what I'm saying?
You don't fuck with strip clubs at all, though.
You say what?
You don't fuck with strip clubs at all.
No, I ain't gonna say I don't fuck with strip clubs at all because there's titties in there. But
yeah. You've been before.
I've been once.
Yeah, Mike, have you ever been?
I dabble. And then, man, there was a period when me and Lady, man, we like was going together. She wanted to, you know, see me, you know, interact. And, you know, it was grand. But it was, I think I enjoyed it more alone. Yeah, I could be me.
I could be me. You're fucking me. Ah! No, but I became more of a strip club fan probably after a trip to Atlanta. After hanging with some niggas that drank, it was like combination, because in Atlanta they sell liquor in their strip clubs. A lot of the laws, give or take what city you're in, is you can't have fully nude and alcohol, or something of that extent, right? And one thing that good strippers are good at is they are very conversational. It's like naked women. Just talking is a thing. That's kind of what they do. They kind of just be naked and friendly and talk. Like all the dancing is like, me watching you on the stage dance, just feel creepy. Like, it just feel weird. It's like, do something for that dollar. Yeah. So 15,000. She kind of got gypped for 3 hours. It's like, was that $5,000 an hour? Is Kanye, he a billionaire? I don't know. You kind of got, you know what I mean? I guess he was like, that was very frugal. Because every time a stripper's with you, she's spending time, right? So it don't matter what she doing. Like a place could not have, you could not be getting a lap dance and it'll just be a cool stripper over there talking. But you got to give her money, nigga. She's literally here. Like one of the security niggas, but hey, bitch, you got to move around. That nigga ain't spending no cash. So I'm imagining him just talking to her about shit and just spending like just throwing dollars as he's talking to her. Like that's 15.
At you think he did it like that? You think he threw it as he was talking to her?
You kind of put it on the ground, and or you got to spend it at the end, because they can't say, all right, give me money at the end for talking. That's not how it works. That's not how the transaction works, right? So a lot of times you'll be talking to your boy, whatever, and they'll be there dancing, be like butt cheek, yeah, man. So I'm telling you, man, we gotta start doing more real estate, butt cheek, like that, like you're in a conversation and they're kind of there, and if they're halfway savvy or if they got like some businesses, then they might also just be naked. Strip clubs are when are strip clubs opening back up?
They've been open back up depending on what state you're in.
Shit, I gotta see what's popping in California. But yeah, so very often they just be like a company in the space nude, and they'll be dumb friendly. They might sit on your lap or like, and you'd be talking, nigga. You'd be kicking it with your peoples, and if you drink, then I guess you're drinking, and don't let it be in Atlanta, nigga. You be eating some good lemon pepper wings and titties, and this is a good time. Hey man, if you was gonna ever spend a lot of money, why not here?
And man, to your glitter point, I don't even think it's like you don't want your girl or other people to see you have glitter on. It's just hard to get off.
Yeah.
So it's really difficult to get glitter off, even when you think you got it all, man. It's like a week later and it's still some yellow and blue glitter, you know, in weird places, like right under your chin. Like, well, like, where was your mouth? You know, so.
It's always don't have no mustache, no big chin here. Oh, it always get in here.
All right.
But you got to cut that shit off and start over.
It's always, yeah, it's always glitter is like, it's sand. It's sand. It's like colorful sand. Cause sand be the same way. You'll go to the beach and then 6 months later you'll be like, nigga, where all this sand coming from?
That's why I don't go to the beach.
Me neither. I don't go to the beach because I ain't got no beach yet. I don't have no like,
you don't have like a raft. Ball
throw. I don't have a raft. I don't have no
frisbee. You have a frisbee? I thought you had a frisbee.
I don't have no
floating. I know you got some big baller brand sand shoes.
Nope. Only got tennis shoes. I don't have many sand shoes at all.
You don't have a beach ball.
I don't have a beach ball. I don't have football.
Time out. Do we know anybody with a beach ball? You ever met somebody with a beach ball?
just sitting around?
Yeah, they just got a beach ball at the house because we all know everybody got a basketball.
I know one, Bombay, nigga, Any of your slightly creepy homeboys has always got like, yeah, man, come through, man. I got some, I'm on the boat, man. Man, come through. I got some people coming on barbecue. Whoever that nigga is, he got a beach ball.
That is ridiculous and accurate.
Whoever your friend is has always got some shit going. That is.
You got a beach ball at the crib?
But I don't know nobody like, I don't have one. You got one, Mike?
Nah, I don't have a beach ball.
I don't have a beach ball.
But look at this. People don't have beach balls, but oddly enough, everybody got like a tennis racket.
Yeah. Just somewhere floating around.
Everybody got tennis rackets though.
Even if you don't have a tennis racket, you got tennis balls.
I got golf balls. I got golf clubs. I got 6 basketballs.
Wow.
Why? I got football.
Why?
What do I got? 6 basketballs?
Yeah, why you got 6 basketballs?
So man. I bought 1 basketball and then I would go to the gym, and so when I go to the gym after we hoop, I would go lift afterwards. So when especially when you hooping at like specific times, it's usually like a group of people. So everybody know, 9 o'clock is gonna be about 15, 20 of us. 5 a.m. we had those runs.
Yep.
So what happened is, let's say the 5 o'clock run is done at 6:30. Everybody goes home. I go lift. When I go back in the gym, if it's a basketball left behind, I got a new basketball.
Oh, so it don't belong to the gym. Like,
no.
You just like, hey, it's mine now.
Yeah. And that happened 5 times.
So you just pack it up in your bag and just dip out.
Yeah. And I'm gonna tell you how I did it, right? I'm not super proud of this way, but it's like, and it's literally like I'm looking around, like everybody's gone. So I'm like, I'm looking for names on balls. And then if somebody say I left my ball, it's like, oh yeah, I got it. And you know what I mean? But I would always have my ball with me in my bag. So I would take my ball out my bag and put the other ball in the bag and hold my ball out.
Mm.
It's like, no, this is my ball. I don't know what other ball you're talking about.
Lance take a Sharpie to the gym and write his name on the ball.
You gotta write your name on it.
No, I don't. I only got my name on one ball. So I got balls with other names on them. I got a ball with a phone number on it. Like a, if you find me, here's my. I'm not calling you. Like, yo, I got your balls. Like, that's nigga.
That ain't what you did.
Yeah. Man. Hey, I got your ball, my nigga.
But you know
what, that is for ransom.
Les, wouldn't nobody even be mad at you because you are a nigga that get picked up. Nigga, if I have the ball, that's gonna be a goddamn problem, man. Who the fuck got my ball? When you are, I got next, nigga. Niggas don't like that shit. You can't. Niggas be mad when I have the good ball. Niggas be mad. Nigga, where you get this ball from? It's mine. You don't ever use this motherfucker.
That is the worst. When you got the good ball and niggas don't respect your hoop game, because then it's like, yo, we running with that rock. But then, because that nigga always got to leave.
Yeah, I'm going to have to leave early. You don't pick
That's
me.
That's what I'm saying. So, yeah, I got to go. I need that rock.
Yeah.
Come on, bro. Let me bring it back. Nah, I got to go, bro.
Oh, nigga.
Right. And then to keep the ball, you got to pick him on your team. Now your team got a liability.
Oh, well. Should have got you a ball, baby.
It's a liability that none of you so-called hoopers got a basketball. How about that?
Yeah, that's tough.
Let me tell you who I was never, though. I was never the nigga, the nigga at my skill set that was overdressed. Like that, that's bad. When you know you just play basketball for fun, nigga, don't be getting all these shits, nigga.
You got the shooting sleeves.
Oh, my God.
The headband, the mats, the shorts with the wristbands. You got the newest shoes on.
Oh, brand new shoes to hoop in.
Yeah.
You brought the powder to the gym.
Oh, I got a $75 budget on hooping shoes.
nigga walk in with slides on, holding his shoes. Like, nigga, you walk in with your shit on, ready to go.
We ain't got time for you to lace up, bro.
They ain't got time for all these wardrobe changes, my nigga. You come in, nigga, just in case.
Nigga got on the snatch off pants. I'm ready, coach. Let go.
Even when niggas is really good. Like, it's one of my pet peeves, right? Is getting games going and keeping them going. I'll be like, bro, we here to run and work out. And, you know what I mean? We going to compete. But, bro, like, anytime, like, it's like after a game and niggas go get water, I'd be like, bro, you ain't even do shit, bro. Like, check up, man.
Hey, man, I know who does that. I do that. Because I need to breathe in between the games, man. I'm trying to recoup 100% fully. So I don't go to the nearest fountain. I go to the water fountain on the whole other side of the gym. And I'd be the last dude, and they'd be like, oh, you still running? That's how long it took me to come back. Because then it make my gym experience way longer. Because, you know, like, if I'm tired and we lose, I'm done. I'm not getting picked up again. So
this is what we did yesterday, right? I got a homegirl. She ran a gym. She owns a gym where she trains at. Mm. So it was only 10 of us hooping yesterday. We was like, okay, bet. Seven game series. Rock out. Everybody gonna get some work.
Oh, nigga, that's hilarious.
After the game, I'm like, yo, check up. Niggas gonna get water and sitting down. It's like, bro, what are y'all doing?
We played to 11, nigga.
The games was to 13. That's a random number, but this game's to 13. It's like, yo, all right, y'all about to get the work again. Check up. We won that series in six. We lost the first game. I put that on me. And then we won the next three. I put that on me too. And then we lost game five, and then we closed out in game six. But speaking again, because that's when the Suns closed out the Lakers, right?
So Mike, so here's an interesting question, man. When you the Lakers aren't playing basketball right now. I don't know.
Why is changing your number news? Like, why is it important right now that we know that? Can't we just watch the playoffs without you being in it? Can't we just enjoy
Is that what you felt, Mike? Did you feel like a reaching for attention?
I did. I'm like, oh, this what we need to know right now, why KD's getting his life and really taking ownership of this GOAT label. It's like, that's what we want to talk about.
What happened? I don't know what happened.
Yeah, LeBron said he's wearing number six next season. He changed from 23 back to six.
Well, that's very important. He tried to do it this year and he couldn't. Because
he tried to do it when Anthony Davis got there. He tried to give Anthony Davis number 23. But then they said Anthony Davis is keeping number three. So Who knows why he switched numbers?
Well, maybe he'll switch it. Maybe he won't be on the Lakers anymore.
Who is that?
Oh, LeBron for Dame. I feel like that's a good trade.
Hey, man, if I was a team owner, I would tamper. I would always tamper.
Big tamper.
I'd be a tamperer. Right.
I'd be a tamperer. Wait, Mike. Now, Mike, people don't think you can play, but you can play. Nigga, what is your attitude when you go to the court?
Yo, man, I know I'm going to annihilate because they don't believe it. Right.
You hey, feel man. Like me doing stand-up, nigga. Yo, so,
hey, man, I hate to say this, man, because, like, we supposed to live out our dreams and stuff. But I lived out my dream yesterday, man. I was hooping. You know, man, I talk about I have an unmentionable amount of children. Mm-hmm. So
we too. Ran.
Yeah, see, we ran, man. I ran threes with two of my kids, man. And we ran it hooping yesterday. And that was like the first time all three of us, not like all, like Stepman wasn't even there. It was two other ones. And we balled out, man. And it was like, yo, man, this is wild. They was hitting threes. Like, I'm like showing moves off, man. And they like heard me talk shit forever, but I don't think they knew that I had it, you know? I'm like, man, I'm like Chris Paul too. I'm like, no, switch. You stay there. No, hold man. Hey, lock him. Like, I was talking, man, and we was winning games. Yo, it was a very... amazing feeling.
You was out there being a floor general?
I was a floor general, man. The least athleticism, but it was all like vet year, like 20 years in hoop game.
Yeah.
That dude, I was that guy. I was Tree Rollins.
Big IQ.
Yeah, it was a dream come true, man.
He said I was Tree Rollins.
Now where were y'all playing at?
We was at our park. We was at a park, and it was just enough where people was running threes. And the other team had picked, like, they just, the way it ended up, we just ended up on each other's team.
That is hilarious.
And then, man, it just ran the board, just ran it. And I'm like, it was wild. It was special. Yeah.
I don't know. Man, I played a fair amount of football in my life. Baseball. I don't know if people know the joys of basketball. Has got to be the most fun game.
It's gratifying. Yeah.
It's instantly gratifying because somebody gets you, you can get them right back. It don't like, and hitting a game winner in basketball is, on any level, I don't care. It feel good. It really feel good for me. Oh, because I be talking cash shit. Because you left me open, bitch. Penny. Like the frustration niggas feel when I hit the game winner for two. It was a two-pointer too, nigga. Them niggas be mad. Top of the three, nigga. Pennies, bitch. Whoo! My team be confused. Everybody be confused.
BT come out there. You don't give a fuck about matching. I'm talking about blue shorts, gray and yellow shoes on. Hey. And the shoes is like, we all like, nah, I ain't never seen those before either.
White beater. Just the hoop.
Yep, he got those just to hoop it. White beater. One of the white beaters. It ain't the full Andre the Giant shit.
It's on the white beater.
The white beater has been through some shit. we're not supposed to say white beater no more, right? Undershirt.
Hey, man, did I bring that up on here before?
I don't know.
All right, peep this. It's a guy, his name is James Hartford Jr., white guy from Detroit. The story is back in 1939, 49, 59, or 69, or whatever, he beat up his wife, right? And the news posted the picture of this guy, and he was wearing a dirty, beat up white tank top. Mm. So that's what happened. That's how the shirt got his name, because he was the biggest known beater of his wife. And that's what? The story's origin.
No, wait, what did she do though? Never mind. We don't need to know that. we don't need to know that part.
James Hartford Jr. Yeah.
The origin of the wife beater.
That's the origin of the wife beater. I just happened to look this up like 2 weeks ago.
Wait, Lance, tell them about the game winner though, nigga.
So look. And oh shit.
Oh my God. Dude, that should be.
Yeah. No, that's actually not him, though.
That's a movie.
That's the ad that comes up. That's Marlon Brando. But yeah, but that's it.
They say the origin of it. But
I wish I could find them damn shoes. I wish they was close to me.
Yeah. Hey, when I tell you these shoes is some bullshit. So he that on the wife, the undershirt, the James Harper Jr. on. And a fucking back brace. No. A back brace outside of the shirt. So everyone can clearly see that he's not 100%.
That's the reason.
So James Harper Jr., these shoes that no one has ever seen before. And I don't mean like exclusive. I mean like we don't go to that store.
No, nigga. The Nike Tech though is like that bitch was screen printed on.
Oh, and no visible socks. So
oh no, the sock tucked away. Gotta only got ankle length socks.
So imagine this, my BT take the ball out. Now BT does this thing when he takes the ball out. It's a no look pass, but everyone knows where he's looking. Yo, he'll literally go like this. He'll go like this. He'll throw that. And he's like, and he'll do it for so long. He's like,
that's the go-to.
That's the go-to. And he'll throw it like a fastball, like, and he make a little sound effect, like.
Right? That bitch always get there, don't they?
And sometimes he'll jump a little bit when he throw it, like. So. Cool. He throw the no look looking pass. But then the rotations happen. Double come over here, whatever. So he's still at the top of the key from taking the ball out. Oh. And
oh my God, nigga, that's funny.
So imagine this offense happening. Game point, we need two, right? Say this game's to 11, it's 9-9. You know everybody going for that two ball at this point, right? Boom, you can't get off. Somebody come check the screens, trap the screen. Okay, swing it. Only thing open is BT. BT catches the top.
I ain't left the goddamn top of the key the whole time.
He ain't left. He's still standing there from the no-look looking pass.
No, he adjusted the top of the key. Back brace.
He had the top adjusted his back brace.
Look. Oh, my God, bro.
When BT catch it, it's like the defense don't, like, oh shit, we gotta get back. Everybody kind of stop, like,
stupid motherfuckers.
Like, is he gonna do it? Because it's kind of like, if I fuck it. So he'll catch it, but he don't, like, it ain't like he catch it and pull up with confidence. Like, he catch it and, like, look around, like, oh shit. And then once he see that, I can't really pass the ball because I'm two by myself. could just shoot that bitch.
He Ben Simmons that bitch.
Ben won't even shoot it.
No. That's how I know that nigga's a hoe, nigga. Pull that shit, nigga. Fuck it, bro. Pull that shit, my nigga. You ain't gonna walk. If you ain't gonna walk off me, nigga, you can't walk off. Y'all got me fucked up, nigga.
And this the cold part about when BT hit the game winner. I seen him do it two or three times.
This happened.
Nigga, yes.
I'm telling true stories, right? I've seen this happen two or three times, and I've seen it happen in Sacramento and in LA. So it's not a fluke. No, Mike, no exaggeration. The shot is always the same. It's like a line drive. It's like the shot is real line drivers, right? But one or two things happen. I'm talking line drive, all net, like where they make the noise.
Yeah.
Like, oh, this nigga shot a perfect shot, but it looked crazy and it's a line drive. Or that bitch hit up the backboard so hard and go in. It's like it's a bank shot, like it smacked the back. Don't you ever leave me open. Like,
oh my god, bro.
And they say that when it hit the backboard. Don't you ever leave me open. Hit the backboard and it go in. And I'ma tell you the truth, man. When a nigga hit a game winner off the glass like that, everybody wanna fight. Everybody ready to fight.
Oh my god. Hey, wait, Mike, this be the cold part, nigga. I ain't got no other points. Nigga, I ain't got no other points, man. And I'm talking, get the fuck off the court, nigga. Oh my god, bro.
And when I say, look,
I ain't had no points for three games.
Not only no points for three games, but probably only took two shots. And what, like, because the last time he took that three, that bitch just off the backboard.
Oh my god!
It just went off the back. It was like the nigga just threw the ball at the backboard.
It was an alley that niggas didn't know. I looked right at him.
Yo, man. Or a nigga might because it's a lot of times been at the top of the key. So if a nigga at the top of the key and you like, nigga, just cut to the basket, nigga, you're gonna be by yourself. But niggas like, nigga, I don't want to.
This is where I should be, you guys.
So it's like, a nigga might be under the basket just because niggas told him to. He'll get under the basket and like, I don't mean like miss a layup. Like, I'm talking about like, what the fuck just happened to a layup? Like, I'm talking about lay the ball up but throw that bitch over the basket. And you like, yo, what the fuck?
Oh my god.
Imagine niggas 0-for-2. A layup that went over the basket. A three-pointer that almost broke the fucking court.
Hey, Mike, after all that, get the fuck off the court, nigga. You niggas is garbage. Talking cash, nigga. Bro, that shit feels so good, fam. Oh, man.
Hey, are we saying it here first that BT got elevated crunch time numbers?
Oh.
Yo, that's crazy, man.
Nigga, Mike, the shit, bro, the shit be feeling so good because it's, nigga, I really just be playing defense, getting rebounds, nigga. That's it, bro. That's really be my goal. I'm out here for cardio, baby. I'm out here for cardio and a good time. You hear me? I'm going to send some picks. I'm going to make some passes. I'm going to hustle hard. I ain't going to fuck nothing up. But go back to last Tuesday's show. Hey, man, you got me fucked up if you don't think I think KD said that shit. I think it's the shit I be saying. You got to say, don't you ever put me in a conversation with that nigga ever in life, bro. He not me. I don't know no niggas good at basketball that don't talk shit. I don't know niggas that play basketball that don't talk shit.
I don't have fun if I don't talk shit.
That is fucking hilarious, nigga, because I ain't never seen it from another nigga's side, nigga. That is the nigga that no look. I thought I was getting away with that bitch.
Nigga, it looked like, you ever see like when a kid think he getting away with shit and you see him, but you just let him do it? That's how it looked like. Nigga, you say, my nigga, just ask for some cookies. You can have some cookies, bro. But you sneaking these bitches in your diaper is just nasty.
Lance, let me tell you how stupid the logic is for me. Because I play defense so hard, nigga, I'll steal that inbound pass. So I'm thinking everybody playing like that. It's like, nah, these niggas ain't play like that. They gonna get buckets. They don't need to do all this extra shit, nigga. That's why I can't play right now, nigga. I was like, nigga, but oh man, come hoop. I was like, bro, the weight I'm at, y'all don't understand. I have to play basketball at full speed all the time to even have a reason to fucking be out here, nigga. I can't lacklusterly play full basketball, nigga. Nigga, I'm like, hey man, what the fuck is old boy doing, bro? Fuck, nigga, that is fucking hilarious, bro.
So when's the last time you played? Because you hooped yesterday, you said, Mike?
Yeah, I hooped yesterday, but I'm every time I hoop once, I'd be ready to join the league because it'd be that good of a day. And I'm like, all right, man, shit. Like,
hey,
like
man.
Last time I played, man, I started betting people on Facebook, man. I started challenging them to pay games one-on-one, and nobody had the time.
When did you know you were good? So, cause like, okay, for me, right? Like, I know this is when I knew I wasn't good. Nigga, one day. I remember this shit like it was yesterday, nigga. I was with niggas, I hoop it all the time. Bro, I was on fucking fire this day. I don't know why I came out, shot the first shot, but that bitch had an arc and was all cotton. Whack! Niggas gave it back to me. I hit the next one. Whack! Niggas, they scored, so it wasn't a blowout. Then I came out, hit another two again. Whack! Niggas quit. Niggas like, hey, man, I'm done, bro. I'm done. If this nigga shooting like this, I'm done. I'm not playing. And niggas went home. I was like, nigga, it's the best game I've ever had in my life that didn't get completed. So that's when I knew I was bad, nigga. When did you realize you were good?
Seventh grade, Baltimore, Chicopin Parkway. And, man, it was all these parks, man. But, man, I had handles. So, man, like, you the short dude, and you just that. Not making a damn thing, but you crossing people up. So back then, the crowd is watching, and every time you like that, they're like, oh!
Yeah.
Shorty, nice. You just kept hearing that. Shorty, nice. And I'll do a pass here. I had no J yet. I didn't get a J till like ninth grade. You know,
right.
Like, da, 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 da. And that was it, man. That was it. It was just dribbles. And
you just had control.
Yeah, man. But people were saying it. So I was like, oh, yeah, I am nice. I do practice every day at the school. Da, 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 da. So.
Man, nigga. Lance, when did you realize it?
I want to answer this question, but I have to acknowledge what you just said first. You were hooping so good that niggas quit because they said, if he's playing well, I don't want to play. That is, okay. Take it out of that. Think about it from our perspective as comics.
Right.
Go to a comedy club and a comic is ripping. He's like, man, nah, I'm not fucking. If he ripping, I'm the fuck out of here. Like, yeah.
Forget comedy.
imagine the crowd doing that. The crowd like, yo, if this nigga funny tonight, I don't want to be at this show.
Yeah, right. And Lynch, you got to know, nigga, I grew up around hoopers, but I fought basketball for hella long, nigga. This is how crazy it is. The hard off the backboard shot, nigga. Remember the Walmart basketball goals?
Mm-hmm.
With the loose screws? Nigga, all you had to do was hit the backboard hella hard. Nigga, yeah. I never changed from that. Nigga, it was always throw that bitch at the backboard hella hard into the square, and it's going in. And the whole goal say, ra 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 ra, and a screw fall out that bitch. And it was some sand and some water and some rocks on the back of that bitch so it didn't tip over. Nigga, That was like the first basketball I played on, nigga. But it was football all before that. And I was never fast, but I was always quick. And I had reasonable hands. And then, we used to play tackle on concrete. But tackle from niggas you know is different than tackle from niggas on a team who got something to prove. Yeah. It was just like, one tackle, nigga. I said, I'm done with football. That's it.
Yeah. Man, that is funny.
Nigga, so, that is a fact, nigga.
When I knew I was good at basketball, that's a tough question. I remember myself, this will probably be the easiest. It was in high school. So this is ninth grade going into my sophomore year, summer school, summer league. Mm. So we're going through summer league. And I was on the summer league team. And at this point, the coaches had never seen me because I didn't play freshman year. I did like this open tryout freshman year.
Yeah.
And after one workout, he was like, yo, you probably should be playing at least JV as a freshman. But then when they went to look at my grades, they said, you should be in third grade. Mm. I had a 0.67. Failing every class except PE.
Nigga, hilarious.
So it was like, yeah, this ain't gonna work out. They's like, yo, we can't even spend time with this no more because it's just nothing's gonna come from this. I'm talking about I was dogging these niggas in the way. It was like crazy. It was like dogging these niggas, right?
This is why you ain't studying.
Yeah, y'all niggas doing homework. That's why y'all fucking suck. So now we're going into this is summer league. We playing at Laguna High. Yeah. And I'm on the bench the whole game. And I'm like noticeably frustrated. Like, I've never played organized basketball. Like, I played on like teams and stuff, but not to this level of organization. So I'm like, man, put me in the fucking game. Like, I don't know. I'm not supposed to say this out loud like this.
Yeah.
She was like, come on, you in. And this was like probably the third or fourth quarter. Mm. And I got like 6 steals. On like 8 possessions.
Wow.
It wasn't like, I'm talking about somebody come up court dribbling, I just take the ball from them. It was like, and that was in the 2000s, that was Allen Iverson. So that's when everybody was doing like all of that. And I just had real good timing and instincts and footwork. And I had, I guess, long arms for a shorter person.
Yeah, long arms.
Exactly. I just had good instincts and anticipation. So I kept taking the ball. Like it was crazy.
Yeah.
It was insane the way, and it was like, what? You know what I mean? So that's when I knew, because that's what I'm playing. I was like, that's when I knew like I could actually play basketball if I like, because that's organized, that's refs and coaches and all that.
Yeah.
And it wasn't just the steals. I was making like some incredible passes that were not incredible to me. It was normal. And this, you got to remember at this time, I was blind still. I just started wearing contacts until I started doing comedy. So I couldn't see.
This nigga was using the force.
I could not see, bro.
Yo, he pulled the brawn.
I can't even see.
And, you know, if... Oh, no, y'all have both seen my glasses, so y'all get it.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. I see.
Like, I was going... But y'all seen my glasses, so it's like, no, bro, I'm... When I tell you I could not see
like this, man.
Yeah. Yo, what's that Martin character, man? What was it? Was it Otis?
Otis with the Otis. Yeah, man. So, like knowing that, and then because especially in organized basketball, when you got plays, all I need to know is that's the play. So it's like if you say a screen roll. All I got to do is trust that the roller is going to be in that spot.
Mm.
All I got to do is deliver a bounce pass.
So you didn't know the plays like that. You didn't know the plays on paper. You was like Nick Cannon on Drumline.
No. I knew the plays. That's the point. I knew the plays, but I couldn't see the details. Mm-hmm. So, like, there was this one play in particular that that no one else executed except me, because it was like a backdoor lob. You had to throw a lob up on a backdoor, and we had I don't think he dunked it, but he caught it and finished it, and nobody else, because you have to be able to trust your instincts to throw that ball. You have to have the accuracy to put it on point, and then a part of me could not see if the defender was there or not. You know what I mean? So it's like, yo, this the play. When he go there, put the ball in the air and let him make a play. Now, if I could see, I might have been like, nah, the defender's back isn't turned. I might not have done it. The same with these, like the pick and roll stuff. It's like, bro, you just throw the bounce pass. I couldn't see the details of if it was defender's hands there, nothing like that. I just threw the ball.
Right.
Like other senses, because you couldn't see.
Exactly. Your other senses, and then you just got to trust your instincts and trust that, yo, let that bitch go.
Yeah, because they'll never see you when you're finna throw that pass, nigga.
I know BT, your vision ain't the best either, right?
Went to the spot the other day, found out I had two contacts in, didn't even realize it.
That's tough. It wasn't no blur or nothing. No,
nigga. That shit was crystal clear. I was doing an eye exam. She was like, man, one of your eyes is really strong. I don't know what happened over the pandemic, but like since the last exam, it's like you went from like a -3.5 to like a 1.25. I was like, she's like, I don't know what's wrong with this. And that motherfucker was in my eye, nigga, and I was like, nah. I can see it. Like, let me just make sure. And she went and did the little eye thing. She's like, you have two fucking contacts in.
I was like, what? I hope she said it just like that, too. Yeah, she got two fucking contacts.
But she, nigga, she mushed my eye with attitude. She like, told me both kind of like, oh, my bad. She went back and checked my prescription, was back to where it was. It was two contacts in my left eye.
So, what about you, Mike?
Man, I see extremely well.
Yeah.
I see extraordinarily well. And I use it like it's a superpower, man. I got hand-eye coordination. Like when shit fall out the fridge, I could just catch it like that. Yo, man, I be doing it. Like
Spider-Man.
Towels be falling, man. I just catch them joints, man. Like my eyes and my coordination is impeccable, man. Like I'd be challenging myself, man. I'd be throwing stuff.
Because I never wore glasses, so it was just be blind. Like, I never hooped with glasses. I was like, yo, I'd just rather not see.
Was it because of the glasses? How they looked?
Yeah, I mean, at that time, glasses wasn't cool. At least to me, they wasn't.
Yeah, and you would have had to have goggles on, nigga, because it's basketball, so you would have been out there looking like a science class, nigga.
Yeah, I was searching for identity at that age, so I didn't know if I was a gangster still, if I was pimping. So I'm not finna have no fucking glasses on. I'm gonna have to knock a nigga out just for saying something about my glasses. I'm stocking niggas up for all kind of shit already, so I don't want to add something else to the list.
That's a lot of pressure, right?
You know what I mean? So I was just like, fuck it. You know, when you wear glasses, I think this is why my memory was so strong always, because you start to remember shit. Mm-hmm. I would have to see something and know where that's at. I can't read it. I just know where that's at.
But you was fucking Ray.
Yeah. You ever have to make out something like, okay, I can't see what that says, but I could kind of see something golden, like with a, that's a McDonald's. It's got to be a McDonald's. I can see. You got to use your other senses. You're like, nigga, I can't see McDonald's, but the aura of that image that is blurry as fuck feels like a McDonald's.
I smell patties.
Yeah. I smell an ice cream machine that's down.
Exactly. But all the time, you just like, you can feel the shit, or you just know. I know that that's there, so I know that that's what I want, because that's what's right there. And then so when people start rearranging shit, it's like, bro, you can't do that to me because now I got to relearn some shit because I can't fully see it. Mm. But now, okay, nigga, I be seeing, I can see all this shit in the world now.
Right, eat wrong cereal.
Hey, man, so speaking of being blind, man, I got to talk about this. Speaking of being blind, we saw that meme with the dudes with the work wife.
Oh, yeah.
This don't have nothing to do with that. So, hey, man, do y'all ever had a... Y'all ever had a work wife, man? I mean, at your jobs?
I don't know what a work... What now? Let's define work wife. And so I can better answer this.
Watch this, Mikey. The niggas had seven. Keep going.
This is what I think it is. I think it's... These are people that could already be in relationships at home. But when y'all at work... I mean, man, y'all got physicality, y'all got flirting, y'all got, basically, people see y'all and be like, them two, they go together.
Are you fucking this person?
I think if you fuck them, it cancels it out.
Damn. Are you? I don't know if you are. I don't know if you're fucking them. That, okay, look, that's not the qualifier. You can... But it, even if you're not, it could still be the work husband, work wife relationship.
Because I think if y'all having sex, then that work wife shit ain't cute no more.
Right. The you goal I mean? Is that, you got to work up to fucking.
Yeah. Now y'all just fucking people. Cause I know when people say like, oh, that's my work wife, that's my work. It's like a playful thing. Like we flirt, we talk, we might go to lunch together, but it stops there. Mm-hmm. But if we fucking, then that means we not at work no more.
I ain't gonna touch you. I don't want nobody to know about this shit.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
So this must happen in the hours of the scheduled shift.
And I think you gotta be in a relationship.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
Okay.
Or if you're not in one, you only fuck with this person at work and you don't talk to them when you clock out at all.
Right. Yeah. And shit like they bring you lunch sometimes. Yeah. Like, oh yeah, I cook some lunch. So you want some like that type of stuff?
Yo, I used to have a girlfriend in high school, man, that we only went together in social studies class. But man, like I didn't talk to her. I ain't talked to her the rest of the day. I ain't have her number, but when we was in social studies class, I used to rub her arm. Man, I used to like peck on her neck, man. She used to like get my shoulders and stuff. But outside of that, man.
You had a social studies wife.
That was it. Yeah.
If it, yeah. Hey, she see you like, does this look like six period to you?
Right. I'm in math.
Go ahead, Lance. I'm trying to think of one where they were in a relationship and we never ended up fucking.
No, not ended up, just not in that time period.
Okay, and I'm trying. Okay, well now I'm trying to think of one that was in a relationship specifically. But go ahead, Lance.
No, I definitely had that. I definitely had like a work, like that kind of situation.
I had to have had. I'm way too flirtatious. I just can't think of one where they had a nigga, where they had a dude and or it didn't end up leading to fucking like. Cause I worked in restaurants most of my life. So you really didn't do the, you know, leave for lunch thing. We kind of just ate in the kitchen.
Yeah.
But the flirting with waitress or the hostess was always super fine. The waitresses would always, a lot of time they used to be going through some shit.
Always.
Yeah.
Yo,
what's that about?
At a restaurant, the waitress is always going through some shit. Like, yo, what? Is it the tips? Like, what's the problem here?
Yeah, the good. If you're a good waitress, chances are you going. Your body and face was like going through a lot. The hostess be always be bad. host be right in the, it's the first person you see, she fine. You're going to be a host, baby girl. The bartender, the bartenders be pimping. You can't run no game on them. They didn't hurt at all.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But the waitresses, they be having 2-3 kids. They be stressed out. The good ones, I can't fucking deal with this shit. They got their cigarettes, nigga.
They like stewardesses. Yo, what's up with stewardesses' skin? Y'all ever see that, man? What's up with their skin, man? Is that what happened when you just elevated, like, majority of the time in your life?
With the caked up makeup?
Yo, just with the extra wrinkly all over.
Yeah.
Is this in my head?
Wait, who you flying with?
American this
time. Oh, no. That's American in a motherfucker. That is American Airline got a bunch of wrinkly old, not even old, just wrinkly.
Yeah, but what, how does that happen? Is it from flying or that's who they hire?
That's who they hire.
Like, oh, yeah, you got the amount of wrinkles we need for this.
You're in there. Like you're saying that happens in the interview process.
Hmm.
You look and they say, okay, she's here. You got some experience. Oh, graduated. Oh, top of your class, huh?
Top of your class, huh?
All right, everything checks out. Can you do me a favor? Can you lift up your sleeve? Start rolling that bitch up.
See them blue veins?
Can you start now?
There's a flight leaving at 1.
No, the Delta stewardess, they've been coming through as recently. You know, Delta's hub is in Atlanta, so Delta stewardess be all right.
Yeah, I just never knew if that was the thing though. Cause I always noticed that, man. It just seemed like stewardesses are extra wrinkly.
Yeah, American.
No, on Spirit Airline, they got stewardess, but you gotta pay extra for them. If not, bro, you just gotta get on the flight. Everything is a la carte. It's
you
like
you be out there serving the snacks and shit.
Yeah, just go get it's over there, nigga, if you hungry.
You don't get shit free on Spirit, nigga. If you want to pull this thing down, nigga, your armrest, that shit. I ain't charging for that shit.
You got to put your card in.
You can't. Spirit Airlines is the fucking worst, bro. I took that shit one time. I was like, well, I'm above this.
I just hear the horror stories.
Yeah, man. I walked past it today. So I was, when I was going to get my luggage, you know how they got every terminal that you go to get your ticket in. And the Spirit one looked like a whole different place. You know what I mean? It's like the people over there was different from everybody else and all the other things, man. And it was...
Have you ever flown Spirit before?
I haven't. I just heard the stories.
Let me tell you the problem, the shit that nobody talks about with Spirit. And this is where I know money is an interesting thing. Niggas always talk about, oh, yeah, they charge you for this, they charge you for that. Let me tell you something about Spirit Airlines, bro. Them planes don't feel safe. Fuck the charges, nigga. Nigga, the plane took off. I was like, nigga.
Oh, no.
No, sir. That fit, nigga. Not like, oh, it was in the air and it was turbulence. Like, nigga, are we going to get up? Okay, we're up here. Are we going to get down? Nigga, it was like the whole flight. This is a raggedy ass plane. This bitch is pieced together however they can. I'm looking, shit shaking. I'm like, yeah, this ain't right. Now I'll never do this again.
Where was you flying to and from?
I think it might have been like a Vegas trip or something like that. It was short.
It was like only 45 minutes of terror.
45 minutes of, oh my God, I'm petrified on a beautiful day. No wind, no clouds, no rain, nigga. Just a wreck. This bitch felt like a... You ever be in a nigga car and that bitch got the shit leaning off the roof, nigga? Like it felt like that, nigga. It felt like nah, this ain't gonna make it, bro. Not like a good sturdy old car, like nah, nigga, it's Cadillac, it's metal. Like a fucking Corolla, like a old Corolla. That shit was like a Saturn.
You riding with this shit on, cause and then the inside the shit like keep falling on you.
Yeah, keep fucking up your outfit.
Oh man,
Yeah, nigga, them bitches is not safe. That was my number one. Fuck the prices. I'll pay $3,000 if the motherfucker say, nigga, it wasn't safe. That shit, don't fly Spirit. Y'all stop that. They ain't got no crashes, but they coming. I'm giving it another 6 months. Sitting around, I ain't never seen a plane need an oil change, nigga. That shit was terrible, bro.
Yeah.
Check engine light was on in the air?
Man. Check engine light was on. It smelled funny. I was like, no, hard pass for the kid. I'll never need to get there that bad. I'll never need to get there that bad, man. Never again. Wait, hey, but go ahead.
This is about to be a whole new topic, so go ahead. Unless you got
No, do you?
Hey, man, so what y'all think about Dame requesting J. Kidd for a coach?
Did he say that?
Yeah, he was like, I want Jason Kidd to be the next coach.
Oh, did they fire a boy already?
Yeah,
Terry Stubbs or whatever. He left.
They fired Terry Stotts, and Jason Kidd said he's not going to the Blazers.
So where is he? Yo, Dame Dollar, let me holler at ya. Hey, yo, Dame, stop, bro.
Well, I think it's so this is the thing, right? It's Portland got some like big decisions to make
because this coaching hire is like
gonna be linked to keeping your star there and happy. But see, one of the problems with Portland is how do you get better?
Well, they finna have some money because they're gonna lose Nurkic. Wait a minute. I'm sorry. Am I tripping? Is Mark Jackson just never gonna coach in the NBA again? Are we done with that? Is that
no, over? I think he's becoming the detox album. I think he's that thing that we all want to see coach. But maybe he don't have the interest like we think he does of turning the franchise around.
Because the next black coaches in line are Chauncey Billups, Sam Cassell, Ime Udoka. He played for the Spurs. He's on the Spurs bench now.
How do we feel about the name Chauncey?
As a boy name?
Yo, man, let me tell you. In Baltimore, Chauncey's was the coolest people, man.
Chauncey's right. It's a weird name.
Ass dude, man.
Chauncey sound like a sleazeball, but that nigga got bitches, though.
Yo, that nigga had bitches, man.
Chauncey.
Dude, that's an interesting name. I don't know if I would name any of my kids Chauncey, though. You know, but...
No, because my first introduction was to Chauncey was Menace to Society.
Mm.
That was Clip the Cop.
Right.
Mm. You remember Kane pistol whipped him.
He didn't pistol whip Chauncey, did he?
Yeah.
I remember.
Wait. No, he in Menace?
In Menace,
Chauncey was the one that was sending them to steal the car.
That's when Chauncey was like, yeah, wait till the police get this tape.
Yes, he did.
Yep, he sure did.
Yeah.
Right. Hey, BT, don't tell me you never seen Menace, though.
Oh shit.
Oh, no.
Oh, shit.
Oh. This is a guy who did a top five without all the information.
Oh, snap.
Oh, my shit glitched out. What's up, y'all? Y'all good?
No.
Oh, snap.
Well, no, I saw it. Yeah, my first Chauncey was when old girl shouted that nigga out. I be sitting in the corner running around three. No, diggity. No, down, baby. To my nigga Chauncey.
BT, you never seen Menace.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I saw Menace Society. Yeah, Marlon Wayans, Sean Wayans, Chris Spencer.
He's on the dashiki.
Chris Spencer had on the dashiki. I don't remember that shit.
Oh man.
You, but today, you got to get out the whoop whoop. Yeah, that's, Menace.
Well, this might be a problem, man. This might be a problem.
No, I've seen Menace to Society. I do not remember it. I've seen it in pieces. Like, I'll start it, it's all red and shit, and then, you know, it's like a table, some pow pow, some shooting card, and they go to a store. I remember it was a store and shit. It was a wife beater.
Yo, Lance, what's the best scene? What's the best scene in Menace?
Best scene in Menace.
Let me tell you, I only brought that up because I wanted to say this.
Hey!
Tell me if you got it. Yo. Come on. Hey, man, so it's a scene with old dog in the car, Kane sitting in the back, mm-hmm. and I all forgot who driving. And Kane's like, yeah, we about to get them niggas. And then, what's his name in the back? Kane's like, well, look, man, if there's some grandmas there or kids, I ain't doing it. And Kane's like, them niggas killed your cousin. They killed Howard. I loved Howard. And he's like, man, and he just go through. That's the scene, man. That's the scene.
Yeah.
He did it way better. Everybody need to go back and watch that scene.
No, you got that. It's some classic scenes in a minute. You got the, he tried to give him the tape to put it on set. Man, that shit gets no play in this ride.
Yo, that was Stacy. That was Stacy. BT don't know it.
Now I remember the nigga had like the little S girl and shit.
When MC8 bust in the hospital.
Right. Oh yeah.
That nigga just bust through the door and it was like, you nigga. It was just, and I shouldn't have known MC8 at the time I seen that movie, but I did.
Hey, what did he say? He had to say something like, where are the forms? And they were like, you need to fill out the forms. And she's like, fuck the forms, bitch.
You're fucking me out.
All right, man. We got to move on, man, because BT just staring right now, man.
Nah, man, I know all about that shit. Old dog and shit.
You know you're fucked up, right? That's probably the most famous scene going forward now.
Yeah.
Mm. You know, you know, fucked up, right? So you bought the bottle of beer at a, you know, you done fucked up, right?
You know, I'm gonna tell you what else fucked me up about Minister Society. It always comes on and then I don't want to watch it because I'd be like, man, it's gonna be edited on here. Like, if I'm gonna watch it, I need to watch this bitch in full.
Yeah, I mean, the amount of streaming platforms that there are now,
it's not on none of them.
If you wanted to watch Menace to Society, I'm sure you would have no problem.
BT just wanted to come on. He don't want to have to pick it and
play. Let's check and see. It's not on any of them.
I got you right here. It's on HBO Max.
Wow, that's crazy. I don't have that.
It's on HBO Max. And then everything is on Amazon. You might have to pay $3 for it, but it's there.
Well, I got to just wait till it's on Netflix. It's not on there.
You got HBO Max?
No, I don't have that.
Now you got it?
I think everybody got it.
We was watching at your house when I was there last time.
Huh?
We was watching HBO Max.
My Zoom is tripping today. Zoom is tripping today.
It's right there.
Wait, okay. What's the movie called again?
Menace to Society.
But there's no, how do you type in the Roman numeral too?
Just put in Menace, it'll come up.
Yo, I'll be doing that too, man. I'll be trying to save some excitement for like later in life. That's why I haven't watched Snowfall yet. I'm having everybody
face ass. Out. There you go. Spread this shit around.
I'm having everybody get it out, man. And one day I'm just gonna go run through that whole bitch, man.
I know a girl who never seen Menace to Society. At least she thought she did. She said, I never seen it, but I seen Menace to Society too. Cause the Roman numeral fucked her up. I swear, what are you talking? So I never seen the first one, but I seen Menace to Society too.
Hey, anytime you get that two, it feel good, man. That two is like that two-pointer from long range. It's like, get the fuck off the court, nigga. Your weak ass off the court. You niggas is garbage, nigga. Bust your ass, nigga.